Okay, now let's see how to create a schematic, how to create a layout for the schematic. So this is schematic. So we have here 1, 2, 3, and 4 connectors here with the relay and 255 timer and rest of the component. So I need to create. So first thing that we need to do is we need to actually create generate the netlist first. So we'll generate a netlist. So once you generate a netlist, that netlist you can save it in the system, and now I can open the PCB editor. So just open a PCB editor. So this will open a PCB editor. So it will take some time. So here the PCB editor is opened. Okay, now before I open the netlist, okay, let me decide. I can actually browse all that, load the netlist. I will open the netlist that I created to this PCB here. So this is the, so update the PCB, close. Okay, so here is my components. Okay, so just okay, these are my components. I'm going to use these components, and let me select all these components once and zoom out and place it inside this. Okay, I'll drag it inside this. So this is the work area that I have. Okay, so now here I need to create a board. Okay, so let me create a board. First the outline of the board. Okay, the outline of the board is 50 by, as you can see, 70 by 50 mm. That is the outline of the board that I am looking for. So what I am going to do is I am going to select a board edge here. Okay, so this is the board cut edge. This layer you need to choose, and choose a add graphic line point. So now let's add the graphic line points. I'm going to choose this as randomly, choose a corner from where you want to make a, you know, board outline. Okay, and choose that line, and now you need to press the space button so that that area becomes 0 0. Okay, you can see here dy and d6 here, dy and dx become 0 0 at this point. So you can choose that. Okay, this is the area that I selected as 0 0. Now click there, one point will open. I will drag till 50 mm. Okay, this is 5 mm. Then click over there, end of it. Then you can drag one more. Press the space button there so that it becomes dy dx 0 0. From there again another 70 mm is here. So this is 70 mm. Okay, 70 mm. Click there, space button, once again continue till 50 mm. Click there, space, from there it will again continue another 50 mm. So click this point, you make sure it is 70 mm. Click there, and that's it. So now the board is complete, the board outline is complete. So once you completed the outline, I want to place this component inside this. Okay, so you select all that. So all this component has to fit inside this. That's a major thing that I am looking for. So you need to fit all these components. So we need to plan accordingly which component has to appear where. Okay, that's the one thing that is required. So we will place all the components, connectors at one side and probes at the other side. So you need to keep looking into the schematic as well here. So here you see G1 is a terminal for the sensor. So that we will keep it at one end. So just look at where the G1 is. So zoom in, and you see where is the J1. J1 is, this is actually J4, and J1, okay, J1 is this, I guess. Yeah, J1 is here. Okay, this is a J1 terminal. So choose that J1 and drag it. Okay, so this is a one terminal for the sensor. Then J2 and J3 and J4 are the other terminals for the output. So we can, so these are the J2 and one more is J3. So this is J3. So this is J3. So these are the four terminals that I have it here. So J1, J2, J3, J4. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place J1 one side, J2, J3 and J4 on the other side of the board. Okay. So let's plan this. So in that J3, okay, J3 is a power, actually DC power connection. J4 is actually for the valve. Okay, J2 is actually for the AC. So what we'll do is we are going to place it here. First J1 I'm going to place it inside and I'm going to flip it. So you can just do R here and you can see only the layer of the, you know, outer layer, only that. So it's up to you whether you want this entire the stop silk. Okay, this is actually the silk screen part. Only the part which we need is actually this connector. Okay, other thing is a symbolic representation of it will indicate how the user supposed to connect the screw here. Okay, all the automatic informations are printed actually, which generally we don't look for, but it's better you adjust it such that it will appear on the top silk. Okay, let me move it a little more further. Okay, here. Okay, so I'm going to connect my J1 here and J2 I need to connect. So what is J2? J2 is a screw terminal for the AC supply. So I'm going to have my J2 here. So what I will do is here I'll give J2, I'll rotate it. So here is my J2. This is my J2 and I'm going to connect J3. J3 is actually DC supply. I'm going to connect it over here. I'm going to rotate it. So this is for the DC supply and here I'm going to connect it for the valve. So rotate it. This is for the valve. Okay, I'm going to connect it here for the valve. That's it. So J1, J2, J3, J4. So J1, J2, J3, J4 are the terminals that I'm going to place it now. So next we will see the rest of the terminals, rest of the components that I need. So this is how I wanted to place the component. So this is my perspective. Okay, so you can change it as well, but generally connectors has to be kept it. I think we better rotate it because generally the screw terminal has to be on the outer side. Okay, because we are going to it's like you can just see the 3D visualization, it will be very clear to you. So if you see here in the 3D visualization, you can see how the component is going to appear. So it's a kind of a connector. Sorry, there is no 3D visualization for that, but this particular component doesn't have it. It's actually a header connector where you need to put the wires here and there is a screw terminal to tighten it. So I think it's supposed to be outward. Okay, all the screw terminal has to be in outward direction, so that's better. So I have kept it in the same way. So now let's pull up all the other components into this. So let's look at the circuit diagram, how exactly we have arranged. So we have here a 74 series that's supposed to come near the sensor and R1 and R2 supposed to be near. to the sensor. So R1 and R2 supposed to be near to the sensor. So let me pull up those components first. Where is R1 and RV1 here? I need to pull it out. This is RV1. Then R1. Okay. R1. Then R2 is here. Pull out R2 also. Then R1, R2. Just look at this. RV1 here. R1, R2. Then D1 is there. D1 also we need. Where is D1? R2 and we have U1 here. U1. I can place it here, U1. Then okay, I think D1 is, this is C4. Okay, yeah, D1, I think this is D1. Okay, that is D1 here, so D1 has to come here. Okay, then D2 also there. D2 will come across relay actually later, and this connector I am going to resistor I am going to place it in this way. You can rotate it as you wish so that we can align it in order, and okay, we can fit it here. And now comes U1 and U2. Okay, that is the transistor, and this 5-5 timer I need to connect. So that is actually, this is U2 and here U3. Okay, so U2 and U3. U1 is this one. U2 and U3. So let me connect that also. So here it is U2. And I have the other component here, U3. Pull it out here. Since we are going for double sided, I think it's quite easy now to make this PCB. Okay. And we have these transistors here. Let's see how to fit all these things. C1, C2 also there. Many components are there. So, okay, R2 and R3. Okay, R3 and R4 supposed to be there. Where comes R3 here and R4 here near U3 actually. Okay, I'm going to pull out R4 also. And R3 also. Okay, let me this. Okay, here it comes here, R3, R4, then comes the relay, okay, and this capacitor. I think I should move this around a little bit this side, lot of space here. Okay, so this component also I can pull it down. What we'll do is we'll rotate it, and this also we'll rotate it, and we'll put side by side, so we'll get a more space here. Okay, and I can pull this also down here. I'll use it here, and okay, anyway, I need to give this C3 onwards, so let me place it nearby each other. C1, C2, C3 is actually for VCC and ground, I guess. So just check this, this resistor C3 is actually VCC and ground, so I can put it near this power supply terminal. Okay, here I can put it, that looks better. So it is across a power supply, C3, so I will connect it near the power supply here itself. Then I have C4, pull it down here, C4. Then what are these things? I think C2. Okay, these are the capacitors again, the disc capacitors. Ceramic capacitors that I need to connect here. Okay. Okay. Very small capacitors. Okay. So I placed all that. Then I need to place this over here. Okay, I don't know, I get enough space here or not. Fine, so this relay finally I need to fit it. Oh, thank God. Okay, so that's how this is now connected. So we have placed these components in this board somehow. So, but only the care should be taken is that you place it such that they are near to the components that are connected to each other. Okay, don't connect this relay over on other corner and other components which is straight away connected to that one corner. That's really a bad idea. So keep the component as close as possible in the schematic circuit how they are connected. So see here, this is a relay and this is a diode. So these two components, this D2 and this relay, has to be nearby each other. So in the circuit also here, the D2 and relay are nearby. So don't put this D2 at the one corner and relay at the other corner. You cannot track it in that way. It becomes really difficult and it's not a good design to start with. So now let's complete the connection. Since now the one requirement, so we have satisfied the we are now has to do double-sided PCB. Okay, this is a double-sided PCB that I'm looking for, so I need to use the double-sided PCB here. So now the tracking restriction I don't have. I can actually track it now both the side. Okay, so as far as possible, let's now track it accordingly what we can actually do here. So now do the tracking here. For the tracking purpose, what you do is you go to track here, edit the track sizes here. Okay, click on the track sizes, click on the net class, and now I'm going to say it in mils. Okay, so click on inches here, select inch, and go for the track widths, and now the net class you need to define. I'm going to define this track width as around 20 mils. Okay, and track clearance is 15 mils. I'll keep the track clearance. 15 mils, I'll keep the track clearance. And track width, I'll put it as 20 mils. Okay, this is up to you. Okay, we have already discussed all these things. So this is the major thing. Okay, clearance and track width we will assume for first. Okay, then rest of the thing we keep it as it is and say okay to that. Now start tracking. So 20 mils is the track width and 15 mils is the clearance. Now you need to select whether you want forward or the bottom copper. So if I am in a bottom copper, select B here and track. So whichever way you can. So now let's track this. So we can, as far as possible, whichever the connection that you feel that can be done, you can do it. So let me track with the bottom copper here. Choose this track. Okay. First thing is done. The first connection is done here with this, and the second connection I'm going to do this. Okay, third is done. Okay, I think I can actually tilt this a bit. That's going to be better for me also to track. Otherwise, unnecessary, I'm going to block this. So let me rotate it a bit. Okay, let me put it over here. That looks better. I think let me rotate further. Okay, that looks fine. So that I can track it further for the top section. That's good. Okay. So now I'll use the bottom copper again. I'll connect this here. It's connected. It's connected. And this also I'm going to connect it. Oh, sorry, 90 degree, it's not allowed. So yes, that's good. Then I have a connection to here, to this diode, from here to this, and this to here. Okay, see, sometime if possible, we can also place this component. Let's say D1 can be placed here also. You see this area inside U1, we can place it. There is always, some PCB you can find it actually. Inside a IC in the middle space, they're going to keep some resistors and all. It is allowed. As far as possible, only these pads are to be, we need to see whether they don't overlap and the tracks should not overlap. But we can place any component here inside also. I can place a component if that the physical structure allows it to place. We can place it. So let me do the connection as much as possible now, whichever is possible to route. The rest of the connection, let's not bother much. Since we have a double-sided PCB, we can actually track it on the top layer as well. So that's how it's connected, and okay, I can even track this. You see here, I'm going to give a track line for this now. Okay, okay. So So complete these connections. Okay. Okay, similarly I need to track it here. So I'm going to track this, I'm going to make the connections here. So fine, so okay. So we need to finish this tracking as much as possible, whichever way you can track it. Okay. So finish these, whichever is possible on the bottom copper, finish those things. Others we will try to do it on the okay, I think there is a 90 degree here, so which we can avoid it. Okay, there is a message, I guess. Okay, so okay, this component, where it has appeared. Okay, fine. So now I need to complete the connections that I am looking for. Whichever possible here, I will complete it. Okay, that's completed. Okay, now I need to make a connection over here. Okay. Okay. So let's see here. Now I have connected few of the components here on this side. I'm going for now double sided end. Okay. Let me see. On the double sided, okay. Now few connections are, for example, this capacitor I need to connect here. So what I will do, I will now on the front copper, you see here I selected the layer as front copper. Now start routing from the front copper and start making the routing on the front copper like this, and you can straight away connect to this point. So it's complete. Sorry, once again let me do that. See what you do it. I need to connect. See, now this is in the bottom. Whatever in the green color that you have plotted is in the bottom copper. Okay, on one side of the board. Don't think that now we are capable of doing this fabrication on both side of PCB. So you are free to route it on the top layer also, bottom as well as top. So now you need to change the routing layer as front copper and choose this track Now you see this connection, I cannot do it on the bottom copper because I cannot route, because there is a line already going here, it is blocking me. I can't go by this way. I can't go by this way, there is another block for me. So if I want to connect it to this point, that or this wire, I cannot do it, right? So the only way that I can do is I need to go to the change layer to the top and route it either this way and connect it here, or I can use this way. So either I can go here, either I can start from here and go like this, then connect to this point. If you connect to this point, it's as good as connecting to this line, right? So if you start routing, see here, click here. So now it will tell you need to connect this to these point, these lines, anywhere here you need to connect. So nearest path for me is here. So I will start from there. I will route it to here. Okay, that's how I connected this. Now what is left? So here one more connection is there and I need to do for in these wires. So what I need to do, I need to connect here, then come like this, connect it over here. So it is connected now. Sorry, it should be connected. One second. So I need to start from here, then here. Yes, it's connected. So I need to connect to this line. See, if this point is common for the bottom as well as the top. Okay, the pads are common to both top and bottom. You cannot simply touch this green line. Green line is indicates one layer, that's on the side. Whereas these pads indicate they are connected to both the layers, top as well as bottom. So you mainly need to connect to those pads. Okay, see, this is not an overlap. Now let me start with the connections over here. So I need to track it, no? So I need to track way to this point. So what I will do is I will track it here. Okay. Done. This connection is done. The only one connection left is this one. Then I need to make it here. So it's possible if I actually pull this component a little bit up. So what I can do here is, anyway it's a bottom copper, so I can start here and I will route it this way. I'll come along with this way. Okay. And take a track. I cannot do like this because there is already a copper layer and it will tell you where to connect, you know. See here, these are the ways you can actually track. It indicates, if you simply go around, it will indicate how you can connect it. See, I can connect it in this way, or if possible, you can put a wire here. I can put a wire here. I can go to the top layer, then I can do the connection. All I'll do is I'll simply click over here. I'll click over here. I'll do one thing, place through wire, okay, place through wire here I'll place through a wire, then I'll start routing further and I need to change the layer again. I will change the bottom copper again. I'll cross over this connection. I'll come here and what I'll do is I'll again place through wire here. Sorry, here. So front copper it has come. Now I can complete the connection. So this is complete. See, you see here carefully. What I did here is I wanted to connect this point to this point, but I cannot do because already there is a front copper is going and there is already a bottom copper are going. So what I did, I started half a way through the front copper, then put a wire here so that I route through the bottom copper, then again gone through the front copper and connected. So this I made a connection. So the double side PCB gives a lot of flexibility in routing. Okay, so it's really easy to make a double side PCB. In some of the tools you can even make it automated. It there is no within no time, within 2-3 minutes you can get the routing done with five. So KiCad doesn't have that feature. We need to have a separate add-on for that. I think that we can look into later, but for the if you know how to route it manually, then I think that's the best way you can actually make your design. So let's have this design here. So this is the way you need to continue making your PCB, and I have fitted all the components. Now I have done half the connection on the left side of the board. Right of the side of the board is connections are remaining. Similar, we need to go through. It will take some more time for me to do it. So once we do it, you start labeling what are these things. Okay, for the labeling I'll tell you what you need. Once you complete the connection, put the labeling here. For whether when you put a labeling here, choose the layer as actually see where you want that labeling to be. Front silk, you want the layer to appear in the front silk. I mean, this is the top layer, no, this is the top of the board. So front silk, I want labeling to be made. So what is the labeling you want to make? So you label it here as what? As sensor. So this is the labeling that I need to do. So this is the sensor. So I need to place the sensor label here. Okay. Similarly, what are these things? This is actually a connector. What is this connector? This connector is a power supply. So you can simply another put label phase and neutral. What is this label? Again, they give a labeling for everywhere, wherever required, you can put the labeling. So this is how you can continue with the PCB routing. So completed video. This video I'll upload it so that you can continue further. And routing is purely independent to each one of us. So we need not have to route in the similar way. You can have more vias, or somebody can have more vias here, and somebody can route it in a different way. So there is no match between them. So I leave it for you to do the routing. So that's it for the class.